The OrgTrack system is built on the Panorama Necto business intelligence software. It's a data cube that is essentially a multidimensional matrix, or array of data that lets users explore their data in great detail by slicing, dicing, pivoting, and aggregation. In this session, I'm going to demonstrate the ways users can view and manipulate their own data in the data cube. This is the home or entry screen, and previews of the views accessed in the last month are shown in the workboard area. We can move to the work area by selecting a preview or by clicking on the Explore Workboards icon and selecting a workboard. In the Workboards task pane, you can see the public workboards with a series of prepared views that provide a starting point for you to view your data. If the pane is taking up too much room, it can be hidden by clicking on the Explore Workboards icon or the X on the right-hand corner to remove. In the Private Content area, you can create a folder structure in which to save and organize the views you have created. You can name the folders and views you create and change the names after they have been saved. You can share a view or workboard you have created with other users. You must first have saved it in your Private Content area. The Slicer navigation bar lists all the slices available in the workboard to slice and dice the data. This is the Cumulative Antibiogram workboard for Queensland Health. In this case, the filters applied are the year 2019, all specimens excluding infection control screens, the laboratory service, and the first isolate per person per specimen per year. To change any of the filters applied, select the slicer, for example, the period hierarchy. This opens a slicer and you can choose another year by selecting or highlighting it, choose 2017, or multiple consecutive years. Hold Shift key down and select 2015 to 2017. You can also choose multiple non-consecutive items. For instance, if I want to change the specimen category, select Specimen Category Hierarchy filter. You can see the current view has all specimens excluding infection control screens. Click on the plus sign to expand the list. Then holding the control key down, select ENT, genital, and tissue fluid pus. Once all the changes to the slices have been made, they can be applied by selecting OK, and the data displayed will reflect the changes. To access the slices available in the view, click on the Dimension selector to access the slicer pane. Clicking on the Dimension selector will display a pivot table. If there is a parameter you want to apply to the data and it doesn't appear in the slicer bar, there is an option to add the relevant slicer by clicking on the left-hand column of the Dimension selector and expanding the dimension you require. Clicking on the blue arrow symbol will expand the list to see options within a particular group of dimensions, and clicking on it again will collapse the list. If the patient category is expanded, you will see that there are dimensions called inpatients and patient categories. To include both of these in the available slices, select them and drag across to the slices box and include the desired slicer in columns or rows as required. Apply the changes by clicking OK. You can also preview the changes by selecting previews with values prior to clicking OK. Now these slices are available in the workboard. In the same way, selections can be made from any of the members or dimensions of the cube. This view is one of selected organisms and antimicrobials relevant for an antibiogram for blood culture isolates. There are dimensions which have been included in the grid that appear in the workboard area. If you want to check which members belong to which dimension in the grid, you can just hover over it and the members of that dimension are highlighted. You can change the antimicrobial selections by right-clicking on the antimicrobial column and selecting the option Select Member. Choose Select Members to open the window. From here, you can select an antimicrobial that has been included in the view from the right-hand side and remove it by clicking the arrow in between the two panes. For example, I can remove amikacin. In a similar way, if there are antimicrobials not in the view you want to include, you can select them from the left-hand side list and hit the arrow between the two panes to move them into the selected list. If you are looking for a particular item in the workboard, for instance, a specific organism, you can click on the slicer at the top of the workboard and either search for the specific item you're looking for in the search bar or scroll down the list and select what you need. Then make a selection from the pop-up window that appears. Example, E. coli. Click OK and the grid displays data just for E. coli. To search in the slicer bar, select the slicer you want to search in. Choose Facility Ward Hierarchy and type in the item you are looking for. In this case, typing in Prince returns all facilities that start with Prince. Select the one you want and the grid displays data for your selection. Where the members of a dimension are part of a hierarchy and you see a plus button in the grid, you can use these to hone in on specific data you are interested in. For example, in this view we have MRSA isolates for 2007. If you are interested in more detail about in which month in 2007 these were collected, just click on the plus sign beside 2007. If you want to know which date in January, click on the plus sign beside January. To collapse these, just click on the minus signs. If you are looking at some data and you want to know more about the isolates the numbers represent, you can drill through to the underlying data. For example, if you want to know more about the Staph saprophyticus isolates tested against ampicillin, click on the number in the grid. Choose Drill Through from the pop-up window to open a window that allows you to choose the parameters you want to see in the resulting spreadsheet. Select Generate Report. This opens an Excel spreadsheet with the details of each of the isolates listed. Using the order number, you can find this specimen in your laboratory database to get further information. If you are interested in the susceptibility profile of a specific organism to particular antimicrobials, you can view this information in this workboard. For example, MRSA. Select any number in the grid for the organism MRSA. Select Profile Report and a pop-up screen appears with the numbers of isolates that match each susceptibility pattern. If you are interested in more information about a specific pattern, click the plus sign in the left-hand column and some details of those isolates appear, which enables you to find more information about them in your laboratory information system. And this list can be downloaded as a CSV file. You can also select items within the grid. If, for example, you want to just look at the beta hemolytic streptococci, highlight the items of interest from group A to group G streptococci by pressing Ctrl and selecting them from the organism list. Right-click the mouse and choose Select Highlighted Members. Then the grid displays data for the cells you have selected. If you then want to only see information for selected antimicrobials, follow the same process. Highlight the ones you want. For example, benzyl penicillin, clindamycin and erythromycin by pressing Ctrl. Right-click the mouse and choose Select Highlighted Members. Then the grid displays data for the cells you have selected. Other dimensions can also be added to the grid if available. Let's say we are now interested in which specimens these isolates have come from. Right-click in the dimension you wish to investigate more closely, in this case, organism. The pop-up box provides options to add items before or after, in the same way as a pivot table. Let's try adding before. The available slices appear. Select specimen category. Select the plus sign to expand the specimen categories, and the grid displays the organism per specimen category. If in fact you want to display the specimen categories per organism, right-click in the specimen category dimension. The pop-up box provides options to remove this. Then we'll add it after organism instead of before. Right-click in the organism dimension, select Add After, then Specimen Category. Select the plus sign to expand the specimen categories, and the grid displays the specimen categories per organism. To save this workboard, select the Save As icon in the application bar. Save to your private content area. To export the data, click on the cloud-like export option on the top ribbon and the following options will appear: Workboard PDF, Workboard Image, Send Link, View PDF, View to Excel, View Image, and Copied Grid to Clipboard. If you require the data in an Excel format, select Copy Grid to Clipboard option and then open Excel. You are able to paste the data directly into Excel without the formatting. You can also save the workboard as a PDF or an image. This is a view of E. coli and its susceptibility to ceftriaxone over time. In the top ribbon, in dark grey, there are many options. Select View and then select the option that appears in the right-hand corner, Layout. The options available are to show just the grid, just the chart, or both. If I choose both grid and chart, both views are displayed. You can change this view to a line graph by choosing this from the chart type options in the top left-hand corner. In summary, the Australian Passive AMR surveillance system, as well as providing a national view of susceptibility data, also enables you to slice and dice your data in many different ways in the OrgTrax Data Cube. You can see both the big picture the data shows you and the very granular detail of that same data. You are able to save the different views you create and share them with your colleagues. More importantly, it enables you to easy access to the evidence required to develop or support local prescribing guidelines and antimicrobial stewardship strategies.